Hello everyone, we'll be back again, part 3 of my Let's Play. Here we are at the next area after Heyday's Flame. Last episode we took out the last giant pursuer and took out Heyday's Flame, beat old Ornstein, and we beat the new boss Dragon Rider, progressed to the inside place and came into a hole in the wall that led us here. So we're going to talk to this NPC. Her name is Lucatiel. What is it? I don't know you, and you don't know me. Things are better that way. Phew. Ha, you're an odd one. Normally people keep a safe distance when this mask is on, but not you. Or when they see this mask, but you. I am called Lucatiel. From the land of Mira to the far east across the mountains. They say Drang Lake brims with powerful souls. And so I came to claim my share. What a strange place, even the rumors did not prepare me. You're an odd one indeed. I've always made a point of avoiding people. While you made a point of engaging me. I can see that you're a mid-journey. If you require assistance, I will help you. I come from Mira, a land of knights. My sword is always ready. Don't hesitate to call upon me. Whatever happens, I won't be missed. You are an odd one indeed. I've always made a point of avoiding people. She's repeating herself. Alright. Basically what she means is she's slowly hollowing and she's slowly forgetting her memories and she's looking for her long lost brother. And she is slowly turning hollow. I don't know if it was there or if it's later in the game. I think it's a little bit later where if you actually talk to her and don't skip any dialogue, she'll take off her mask. Which if you do, you'll be able to see that in her final stop later in the game. Where she'll have her mask off and you'll be able to see side of her face. She kind of reminds me of her Kabuto from Naruto, where he's being taken over by Orochimaru and half his face and body is being taken over. You do not want to die there. Oof. And you can. She kind of reminds me of that. So this area is kind of reminiscent of New Londo ruins, only because there is no other bonfire throughout it, and it's a very short area and it's very dark. Unlike New Londo, there are no ghosts here. There are, though, these Viking-like guys and basic Vendrick henchmen. Almost. I don't know if they're Vendrick's henchmen, but they do look like them. So, we're going to get a Titanite Shard, which is nice. Hey, Viking man. And that is an oil bomb. Those, if you're hit with those fire arrows, will combust your ass upon contact. Or, if you are oiled up and you try to light a torch, you'll burn, which is very bad. This area is very torchy heavy, kind of, as it's hard to see. But, I don't really need to. It's not that difficult to spot places. So we're gonna heal up real quick. Alright. Alright. So we're going to take out this douche so he doesn't keep firing arrows at me. So, you're going to want to cross this little bridgey path here. Come down to grab this little item. It's a large soul of lost undead and life gem. Nice. And then after that, you're going to want to come over here with these buildings in this lighted up area. There's going to be a couple enemies. Three, in fact. One Viking and two normal Vendrick men. And you're going to want to take out the henchmen. Oh no. Roll, please. Yeah, you want to be very careful. These guys are strong for early game. I can tell you that right now, that guy would have killed me if it wasn't for if I would have been able to roll. Dark Pine Resin. That is dark magic resin. Very good for future boss fights that are weak to dark. I don't know if the boss here is. I can always test it on him, though. So, you're going to want to come up this staircase. Well, actually, I want to search some of these buildings real quick. Yeah, I want to search these buildings more thoroughly. I didn't really get a good look. Nope, nothing. Nada. Nada. Yeah, I like to just basically... I didn't really get a good search of the areas real quick, so... And he's throwing bombs at me. Oh, hi! These guys. Those guys. I'll show you how to really effectively take them out. These guys are afraid of fire up until they gain balls. So, when they're freaking doing that, you just pelt him until he's dead and don't give him a chance to gain balls. They afflict some heavy bleed damage that you do not want on you, especially at the later part of this level where there's like four of them. They are freaking strong. Especially much stronger than these guys. So, we're going to come up here. And then you're going to want to come up in this building and up these stairs. There's going to be some enemies in here, so you're going to want to watch out. One enemy. And then you're going to want to destroy this bookcase. Behind the bookshelf is a ring of life protection. So... it nullifies death, but also breaks. In case I do die. Now, if I die, that ring will break, and I'll be able to keep my souls, just like what they were in Dark Souls 1. But unlike Dark Souls 1s, those can be repaired. So you can have basic infinite versions of those. Up, Doge! Doge! Up, Doge is dead. Those are nothing like the Doge from before. Poor time rolls. Varigan cuffs. Varigan cuffs. So, they're weak. Alright. And then, you're gonna wanna come up here, up the staircase. There's gonna be nothing in here. Nothing in here. So never mind that. I just basically helped you out. For anyone who doesn't know, this is for water. I think that's water. It doesn't look like water. It looks like oil. Oh shit, I'm oily. I am oily! So I'm gonna go down here and I'm gonna get this oil off me. In order to do that effectively, is you can basically just come down here and roll around in the water. And now I'm de-oiled, I believe. I believe I should be de-oiled. Yup. Okay, good. I am de-oiled. And, first things first, come over here. We can take off my torch real quick. And get rid of this guy. And then the dog. Get rid of the dog. Always get rid of dogs. Alright. Dogs drop souls of the lost undead and effigies. So they're pretty good farms until they're despawned. So, in here, we can take out at least one or two of these guys before that one over there aggroes. Yep. Alright, now there's a chest behind this table here, this little bar table looking thing. I mean, it probably was a bar at one time, for all I know. In it is the Bandit Axe and the Brigand Armor Sets. And then, nothing behind there, but I like to just knock them out anyway, because you never know. But I know for a fact there wasn't anything. Nothing is going to be better than what I currently have on as of right now. Yeah, no, that's basically like, thieves or stuff like that. Armor set. So there's an enemy in here that you want to watch out for. He does hit through my shield slightly, damages me, but not by much. So in this chest contains repair powder and titanite shot. Nice. So then... you wanna murder. And then I'm gonna pop my radiant life gem and a basic life gem just to speed it up. There we go. And that's a shortcut. And that's also Lucatiel's summon sign. If you actually summon Lucatiel for a specific fight she's at and win with her alive in all three fights, or three fights, that you summon her for, so you can basically summon for her for this fight twice, and then summon her for another fight later on, And if she, and at her final stop, and after talking to her at every stop she's at, and then at the final stop that she's at, she'll give you her armor set for an achievement. If anyone's an achievement hunter, sort of, kind of like I am, but I don't consider it an achievement hunter. I consider it 100% completion. So there is a Pharaoh's contraption. This is useless as it lights up this area. Just that's all it does. It lights this area up, making it easy for you to see things. Not really worth using, especially as how limited they are in the around. You barely find them. Like, I don't really know. I don't really find them that often when I play. So, you're gonna want to jump here and come up here. Oh, wait. First, I want to torch the torch because there's enemies that I do not like. It's the same enemies from before, and they're up here. There's a lot. And eventually, they'll gain ball sacks. But I'm not going to let them. That's two of them. That's two down. There's a bunch more, though. There's a lot more. So, there's a Live Soul of the Undead and the spell Emit Force. And then there should be more. I believe there should be more. I know there's got to be more. I know there's quite a... Yep. Yeah, he's gained some balls. Yep, there he is gaining balls. That's not good. These enemies are carefully strong. Ah, I got bleeding. I got bleeding. Oh, God. Oh, God. I'm going to die here. Yep. Poor roll. My ring of life protection broke, but that's fine. Damn, I knew I was going to die there. The minute I rolled into that wall, I knew it. That's why I wore my ring. My ring. My ring, my ring, my ring. Ring, 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 ring. Bing, 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 ding, 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 bing, 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 bing. Time to go do that again. All right, so basically just go back to where I died. Aye. Kill off any enemies that are bothering me so I don't have to worry about them. I'm gonna murder your face in. Yeah, those guys are powerful, but not to the point where they're difficultly to deal with. I mean, I just usually avoid them for the fact that they inflict some good bleed damage on you. Did he miss? I think he did miss me. Nice. I'm kind of glad I didn't get pegged with that. I'm glad I didn't get pegged with that. So I wanted to take him out just because he was just there. And then we're going to come back this way, over this way, to where we were before. No, don't lock onto them. They're much easier to deal with than that guy. Except for this guy, he feels like the block every hit. So, eh. Oh, what is with you, man? Quit blocking. Quit blocking. Alright. Now, since the enemies are dead, and I don't gotta deal with their ass, gonna come over here, deal with you, and knock you out. Get rid of them. Basically, just getting rid of him. No need for him to be alive. Kill this Viking. Kill the dog. That dog's dead. come back in here and murder them, which was fast, really good, really, really good. Come back out here, murder him real quick before this guy gets a chance to murder me. And then apparently one guy was around, I didn't even notice you. It must be the dude throwing the bomb from above, or that, above that staircase. So, I'm gonna go back down now, and we're gonna progress up that second staircase that leads us to where that guy must have came from. Unless that wasn't him, I don't know. So, we're gonna come up this stair- nope, that wasn't him. Huh, eh, whatever. Oh, no, I'm oily. Yeah, you wanna be careful with these guys. They are strong. Phew. Luckily for me, I know them, and I have experience in this game that I can do pretty good. Dog? Alright. So I'm oily. I'm all shiny. I gotta be careful not to get too hit by fire or anything, or I'll combust. Don't think there's anything behind that. Nope. Nope. So we're back over here, but we're gonna go up this staircase leading back to these bleed fuckers. They drop tattered clothing robes. That's two of them dead, at least. Since they're not afraid of fire, they'll actually attack me, which is great. And I can just deal with them. Versus before, where I had them all bunched on me. So I gotta be careful here, or I'll die, and die again, and, I'll lose my souls this time. Hello! Hi, stamina! Stamina! He inflicted bleed on me, nay. Uh-oh. I don't want my weapon de-equipped, please. Fuck you! Quit hitting me with bleed! Oi! This is not cool. I'm getting too bleed heavy. Down to one life gem, or one Estus. Oh, hi. Stop it. Tattered cloth robe. This should be the last one in this building, I believe. Yes, he should be. Okay. So now we can enter this room where there's an NPC. This NPC is probably one of everyone's favorites, kind of like with Solaire. Great sword! And a trap! Wow, that just misses him. Silver talisman. Transforms to blend into the environment. I'll show that real quick. I'm a bookshelf! This is great for PvP. Well, if you're facing the wrong way, it's not. And if you're not quite up against the wall, it will be noticeable. It's kind of hard to move the bookshelf and turn the way you want. You know what this reminds me of? It reminds me of PewDiePie's Prop Hunter. Who are you? I Gavlon. Gavlon wheel? Gavlon deal. Gavlon want soul. Many, many soul. Gaha. What you want? With Gavlon you wheel? You deal. Gaha. So, you can actually sell your shit to him, which I'm gonna do right now. Oh, I don't need. I'm gonna keep my greatsword for reasons until I get the pursuer's greatsword. I don't need, don't need. I'll keep that for now. Don't need, 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 and don't need. See, I can't sell that even if I wanted to. Even if I wanted to. See? Because it's a DLC weapon. Ported hood, don't need, don't need. Don't need, 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 don't need. I'm gonna eventually go back and kill Malin to get his armor, the Tesladora set, because it gives you more soul consumption, and I'm gonna use that for the time being to level up more. Don't need. Don't need, don't need, don't need, don't need. And that's going to be the armor I'm going to just use throughout the rest of the game, because that's what I use on my main character, and I haven't been wearing other armor since. So. Yeah. See, the ring actually is still in your inventory, meaning it's still there. It's just not broken. It's just broken. He actually sells the increased poise ring and rotten pine resin, which I'm gonna buy 5 of. Alright, talk. Gavlon wheel, Gavlon deal, Gavlon one soul, many, many. Na da 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 da. Okay, that is Gavlon. The wheel and dealing man. What does that lead? So I'm gonna go out this wall. Interesting. So we're gonna put back on my shield before I die, like, pathetically. Oh, okay, this leads right here. Nice. Nice. So basically, this leads to the right way, almost. You're gonna wanna be here. 22 minutes in. Not bad. Yeah, this area is very short. Just like Heyday's Flame, just not as short. So you're going to want to come up this way, kill those guys, and then you're going to want to ring this bell. What this bell does is we'll summon that ship. That ship is the ending. You're going to want to go there. That's the last stop, the stop of this area. Now that it's rung, even if I die, the ship will still be in its position when it floats on up, and I'll be able to progress onto it, regardless if I die. So, fire arrows. Oh god, oh god, oh god! No! I'm gonna get out of here, go open the door! Yes. Yes! I got a backstab on that one. That saved me. I probably would have died if that didn't happen. Oh shit, it's at risk. Poopy. Alright. So we repaired my weapon. I almost got raped, which was bad. And what am I doing? What am I doing? What am I going back up for? So we're gonna go down now. Yeah, be careful of that room. There's not many in that room, but you still need to be careful. You wanna come down here. And then you wanna go in here. And be careful in this room too, because there are two enemies here. That dude was getting off of a chair that broke. Funny. And these jars are filled with poison, so you want to really be careful. And it is Estus Flesh Shards! Estus Flesh Shard, actually. So you can see that it's filled with poison, you can basically tell. Now, to get these without actually poisoning yourself is to hit it and roll back. So, Now that is throwing knife and a flame butterfly. Flame butterfly basically just is what I said before in a prior episode. It's basically the same as a torch, only, or same as lighting a torch on this, except it's instantaneous and you can do it automatically anywhere. You don't gotta actually light that. So, are there enemies around? Enemies? Yeah, there is one. Ishka. Oh yeah, so you're gonna wanna come up here. And there's Lucatiel, but the shortcut is now open. Woot! And we got iron arrows. Nice, see, we're back here now. Nice. Good job, me. Alright. Doing good. Searching through the whole area and doing really good. Alrighty then. So, after that, there was that one spot I did not get to. Now, there's actually a quick little drop-off point that I usually take, that I usually just go through, but I don't do it that much. Yeah, screw you guys. That leads you basically right here. Ah! Oh, hello. Would you stop doing that, please? Oh god, no! Wait, what? Did he get afraid of? He was afraid for a sec. Why? Why are you afraid of me? Stop bleeding me, man! I'm losing blood. I'm out of life gems. Great. So you're gonna wanna come here, you're gonna wanna murder this guy, because they will come after your ass. And you can get this from here. It's a human effigy and a life gem. Nice. Really needed some of those. And then you want to come back up here. These guys will follow you if you don't kill them. To spawn them up here, you just come up to them, hit them once, and they die. They'll fall off. So don't even bother swinging more than once. Do not. If you're that close to the edge, do not swing more than once. You will fall with them. It's happened to me. So, I'm thinking now, did I miss an area? No, not very much. So I'm just going to progress over to the boss. Oh, there's Carillion, an NPC that you could talk to. But you need at least, I think it's either 8 of each faith and intelligence spell, or it's 10 of each faith and intelligence stat. I meant stat, not spell. And he'll talk to you and he'll teach you miracle, or teach you spells. And he'll move to Majula. He's one of the Majula NPCs. And he'll move back after that. But I don't have the stats required for him to talk to me. Because he's an old man and he's a dick. But then again, why would you want to waste your time on someone who doesn't have the smarts and know-how to learn spells and shit? So I guess it's okay. Some of the stuff in this game is actually very clever. Varagian sword. I don't know how to pronounce that word. Alright, so I killed off all the enemies on the boat. I'm on a boat! We're gonna meet a unique boss fight that I actually really enjoy. I think this boss is actually really awesome design. So we're gonna put on Poison Resin. And, jump right into this. I'm not sure if this boss can be poisoned. I believe it can. If not, then I'm failed. It can't fail. This boss is Flexile Sentry! He's not that hard. You want to stay on the club side? That was poor. You want to be on the club side at all times, as he has very discernible, easy attack timings. And very, very good hits to kill him. And you basically could just rape him. He's not hard, and you basically just own him. I'm doing bad because I'm trying to beat him fast, because I'm getting a call! Come on! Flexile! Flexi! Flexile Sentry! Place Flexile! Please, Flexile, please do your attack. Yeah, he's poisoned, all right. Come on, Flexi. Flexi? Smash on the ground, man. Do it, please. Ugh. What? Oh! The poison finished him off. Okay. We're 30 minutes in. Flexile Sentry Soul. Alright, now we can climb up this ladder here. And finish off this area. Alright. We're going to examine that, and you're going to see a small little cutscene of the bell taking off. And now we're going towards the next area, as I am the captain of this ship. I'm on a boat.
I'm on a boat, baby, yeah.
Don't mind me, I do that a lot. And we will be at the next part of the same area we visited before. It's basically another area. Another separate location, but this is the other way to access this area. You'll see when we get there. Take this elevator down. I don't know if there's any items around. Take this elevator down, and then we'll be at the bonfire. Or take it up. Okay, you take it up. I don't remember how to get that item that was in that cave just now. I guess you gotta somehow get there yourself. I don't remember. Ooh, lightning. So, you recognize where we are? Probably not, if anyone doesn't never played this game before. We are back at the Lost Bastille, actually. So, this is basically the inside of it. Anything? No. Alright. So, we are back here at the Bastille. I'm looking for which area has the bonfire in it. There's an item. Common fruit. I'll explain that in the next episode as I'm trying to get through and finish up this episode so I can call my father back. Ah, there we are. Alright guys, if you enjoyed the video, please leave a like, comment, and subscribe. Flexile Sentry was a fun fight, and the poison killed him, which was very funny. And I'll see you all in the next episode. Leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. I'll see you all next time. Peace out, and goodbye. I'm sorry I repeated that, but peace!